name is Dane, and it's Valentine's Day, and happy Valentine's Day to all of you all. The show was fantastic. I love the references, the mask and the feminine, the tuxedo coats were great with the rose appliques on them, and also to the wonderful hats that she reinterpreted from her last fall show with the fur and the knitting, which is gorgeous. It was absolutely pitch perfect. It was one of my favorites, and I cannot wait to buy it in 6 months, and it's great.
Hello, it's Kevin Watson, people. You know, I have so much love for DBF, a.k.a. Diane von Hotspur, because, like, we're here on Valentine's Day seeing some scrumptious fashions. I mean, the runway was full of, like, elite models, but it happened to be, being that I'm one of the flyest creative directors in the game, Kevin Watson, Google me, it happens to be that, like, we actually are influenced right now. Man, it's amazing. When you saw the show, you know, 6 months ago, it was great. It was innovative. But I think that when you look at the Knicks, this iteration of the season, you see a color palette that shimmers. You see a lot of flowing movement in, like, a lot of the materials. I mean, they took a lot of science into the polymers. And that's what it's about. People think of fashion as about what you wear, but it's an extension of the materials, how it connects to the molecules. And I think that when you see the energy of the models and you see the vibrant nature of the color palette that was used, and you see the genius herself doing her thing, combined, it makes it wonderful. But happy Valentine's Day here at Fashion Week 2010, new decade. We love it. And we also love the new blog that you have seen, fully, 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 Vivante. Mwah.